Macmillan Audio presents Eat by Ian K. Smith, MD. Read for you by the author.
This is not a diet book. If you're looking for a book that can improve the quality of your life, make you feel better, look better, lengthen your life, and yes, help you drop those stubborn excess pounds and maintain a healthy weight, then this is the book. In Eat, you'll find scientifically based, easy to understand information about eating well and making smart decisions. The idea behind Eat is simple. Rather than instructing you to follow a rigid diet program that dictates every morsel you put into your mouth, I want to educate you on how to make your decisions so that you feel free and empowered and confident when it comes to making food and lifestyle choices. I decided to write this book for one simple reason. Millions of people anxiously want to understand how to eat better. Yet the advice that many experts dole out is either complicated or contradictory. I wanted to take the best research on healthful eating and boil it down so that after all the fancy language and complex ideas have evaporated, what's left are the essentials of what it takes to eat better and feel better. Anyway, who really has the time or desire to read a 500-page encyclopedia on good eating? This is not a diet book in the traditional sense. Instead, consider this a manual or crib notes on eating that will deliver all kinds of benefits. Yes, you will lose weight if you need to, but more than that, you can lower your blood pressure, reduce your cholesterol levels, increase your energy, feel younger, and fight all kinds of diseases simply by putting the right foods on your plate. Food is our body's fuel, and the purpose of this book is to teach you how to choose and mix this fuel to make sure you are filling up your body's tank with the highest octane available. I've included charts that make it ridiculously easy for you to make smart food choices. Charts such as the best seafood sources of protein or the top 10 antioxidant fruits means that all you have to do is pick from the list. You don't have to comb through a bunch of research papers and articles to create your own. At the end of each chapter is an eat plan with only a few simple suggestions you should follow to incorporate the message of that chapter into your life. I wanted you to have an actual plan to follow with instructions that are specific enough so that you don't feel as if there's a lot of work on your part to follow through with your good intentions in buying this book. I've purposely made the plan flexible enough that you can customize it according to your health preferences. Healthy eating will make you happier and add years to your life. This does not mean you need to break the bank in order to provide your body with the best nourishment. The belief is that only the rich can eat well is wrong on so many levels. And I hope this book will succeed in showing you why. Food experts tend to make the concept of eating healthy complicated. It's not. You don't need an advanced degree or personal chef or even a lot of time in order to put delicious and healthy food on the table. What you need is simple. First, you need to want to eat well and enjoy the food you eat. Second, you need a basic understanding of food fundamentals that will quickly allow you to make decisions on your own without having to consult a book, a nutritionist, or anyone else. Third, you need to believe that good eating is available to anyone who desires it, and not something accessible only to members of an exclusive club. Eat will give you the information and confidence you need to make eating fun, affordable, and life-enhancing. Bon appétit. Chapter 1. Follow the Rainbow. Nature has made it easy for us to remember which foods provide the greatest nutritional punch. Think of the colors of the rainbow. It's that simple. Colorful foods are literally packed with all kinds of vitamins, minerals, and other nutrients that provide us with nutritional reinforcements to not only maintain the body's healthy status, but to fight off diseases that threaten our health. Fruits and vegetables are our greatest sources of health-promoting nutrients. However, we Americans largely ignore these critical natural health resources. A report by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC, has shown that only 32.6% of American adults eat fruit two or more times a day. When it comes to vegetables, things are even worse. Only 27.2% of adults eat vegetables three or more times per day. Beyond vitamins and minerals, colorful fruits and vegetables are full of phytochemicals and antioxidants, two groups of disease-fighting, health-promoting compounds. Phytochemicals are natural compounds in plant foods that work with nutrients and dietary fiber to protect against disease. Antioxidants are food compounds that neutralize or inactivate something called free radicals. Now, free radicals attack the body's cells and contribute to a variety of conditions, including cancer, heart disease, and aging. Thankfully, there are a lot of great-tasting fruits and vegetables that contain antioxidants and help reduce our risk for certain diseases. Loading up on antioxidant-rich foods is extremely important. The benefits of a plant-based diet are abundantly available and clear. Several researchers have studied the eating and lifestyle habits of numerous populations around the world. They looked particularly carefully at the eating behaviors of those who lived the longest and had the best health. They found one critical component all of them shared. Their diets were high in fruits, vegetables, and legumes, and low in red meat. The CDC buttressed this research with a report that showed Americans who ate a more plant-based diet also had the lowest body mass index, or BMI, which meant a reduced risk of the many health problems associated with being overweight. Let's be clear, eating a healthier diet does not mean you have to go to the other extreme and become a vegetarian. There is a very comfortable middle ground that can be achieved by eating more fruits and vegetables and also choosing more poultry and fish and making red meat an occasional meal. To better understand how to choose the best fruits and vegetables to give you the advantage you're looking for, you need to understand just a few basics. Nutrient density. You don't have to become a medical doctor or a registered dietitian or even visit one to know how to make smart food choices. The relatively new concept of nutrient density or nutrient richness is easy to understand and can immediately improve the quality of your life. Nutrient density refers to the amount of nutrients contained within a given volume of food. Foods that are high in nutrients and low in calories are considered nutrient dense. Foods that have few nutrients and are high in calories are considered to be nutrient poor. By simply making sure that 75% of what you eat is nutrient dense, you will see dramatic physical changes as well as an almost immediate energy boost. You can also look specifically at the density of one nutrient. Let's say you feel a cold is coming on and you're interested in boosting your intake of vitamin C. You would look for foods that are nutrient dense in vitamin C. Bell peppers have 174 milligrams of vitamin C per cup and only 25 calories. But fried onion rings contain less than 1 milligram of vitamin C per cup and have 200 calories. The recommended daily value intake of vitamin C is 60 milligrams per day. That means it would take only a third of a cup of bell peppers to meet that requirement and only a little more than 8 calories to go along with it. However, it would take more than 15,000 calories of fried onion rings to meet the recommended 60 milligrams of vitamin C per day. You're between meals and your stomach is growling for a snack. You have a choice. Go to the vending machine and get a shiny red apple or pluck a glazed donut from a box that someone has conveniently brought to your office and left out for everyone. It's common knowledge that the apple is a healthier choice, but why? Apples are chock full of vitamins, fiber, and phytonutrients that will keep you healthy. Donuts have almost no nutritional value whatsoever. An apple answers a craving not just with lots of healthy nutrients, but on only 80 calories. The donut, however, is not only bare of nutrients, but it also will load 200 calories into your system. The apple is nutrient dense, and the donut is nutrient poor. To make it easy for you to make the best food choices, here are a few examples of the most nutrient dense fruits and vegetables. Some nutrient dense fruits include apples, papaya, plums, grapefruit, and strawberries. Nutrient-dense vegetables include things such as asparagus, bell peppers, spinach, squash, and eggplant. Now, to get a complete list of the nutrient-dense fruits and vegetables, just refer to the PDF located on Disc 1 of this program. Your daily fruit consumption recommendation. For many years, the U.S. Department of Agriculture, USDA, has made recommendations concerning the major categories of food products and how much of them we should consume to maintain a healthy diet. The USDA food pyramid, established in 1992, but based on repeatedly modified versions of the 1917 food guide, has been the official guide to achieving this objective. Most people know this pyramid exists, but few really know what it says, and even fewer actually follow its recommendations. In 2010, the USDA modified the pyramid so that it's easier to understand and more relevant to today's way of living. Simply refer to the PDF document on CD1 of this program to look at what these new recommendations are for your daily fruit intake. The USDA offers even more guidance in reaching your fruit consumption goals. 1 cup from the fruit group can be 1 cup of fruit, 1 cup of 100% fruit juice, or 1/2 cup of dried fruit. Now refer to the PDF document on this particular CD, CD1 of this program, to find out more ways that you can understand how to reach your fruit consumption goals. Your daily vegetable consumption recommendation. It's not an earth-shattering revelation that we should eat vegetables every day. But even with years of national headlines and health campaigns to encourage Americans to eat more veggies, we have been falling down on the job. In fact, according to a recent report from the CDC, only 26% of adults eat vegetables 3 or more times a day. This is less than we were eating 10 years ago. The health benefits of a plant-based diet have been well documented, yet Americans still turn to meat and fried foods first. According to the USDA, Americans eat more than 220 pounds of meat per year per person, an astounding doubling of the global average. And our carnivorous habits have gotten even worse. Meat consumption has increased more than 50% since 1950. So, how many vegetables should we eat? Well, the USDA has modified its recommendation, and you can find the simple chart by referring to the PDF located here on CD1 of this program. So, what counts as a cup of vegetables? According to the USDA, 1 cup of raw or cooked vegetables, 1 cup of vegetable juice, or 2 cups of raw leafy greens can be considered as 1 cup from the vegetable group. Now, refer to the document here on CD1 of this program to find out some other examples of what serves as a cup of vegetables. The rainbow breakdown of foods. When it comes to choosing the healthiest foods, don't clutter your mind with all the technical nutritional jargon and scientific analyses. Leave that to the experts. Sometimes just keeping it simple can do the trick. Whether you're ordering food at a restaurant or sitting down to eat at home, remember this. Eat a rainbow and find a pot of health gold. Go for the color and you can't go wrong. Below you'll find what each color group will give you and some examples that you should try. The reds. There are plenty of red fruits and vegetables that are easily accessible, tasty, inexpensive, and pack a powerful nutritional punch. Consuming these foods in abundance will only give you a kick in the right direction when it comes to loading up on vitamins, minerals, and other nutrients. The red coloring is due to natural pigments called anthocyanins and lycopene. Anthocyanins are typically found in strawberries, red raspberries, red grapes, red onions, and other red fruits and vegetables. They are strong antioxidants that protect our body's cells from damage. Lycopene can be found in such foods as tomatoes, pink grapefruit, and watermelon. It's best absorbed by the body when the food is cooked, such as the tomatoes and spaghetti sauce. Lycopene is believed to reduce the risk of several types of cancer, particularly prostate cancer. Here are some examples of the red group: beets, red apples, cherries, red grapes, rhubarb, strawberries, pomegranates, and radishes. For a more complete list, refer to the PDF document on this disc. Oranges and yellows. These fruits and vegetables owe their alluring color to the natural plant pigments called carotenoids. The most common carotenoids in the North American diet are alpha-carotene, beta-carotene, beta-cryptoxanthin, lutein, zeaxanthin, and lycopene. Beta-carotene gets the most attention, and rightfully so. It is found in a variety of foods, including carrots, sweet potatoes, and pumpkins. The body converts beta-carotene into vitamin A, which helps form and maintain healthy teeth, skeletal and soft tissue, mucous membranes, and skin. It's most famous for promoting good vision, which is why our parents always said, "Eat your carrots for healthy eyes." The active form of vitamin A is called retinol, and it produces the pigments in the retina of the eye. Carotenoids are believed to be good for your heart. Studies have shown that people who consume a diet high in these foods had a much lower risk of heart attack and death compared to those who ate few carotenoid-containing foods. One study even showed that those who ate a diet high in carotenoid-rich vegetables were 43% less likely to develop age-related macular degeneration, a disorder that can lead to blindness. So here are some examples of the orange and yellow group. Apricots, plantains, squash, lemons, mango, yellow tomatoes, and pineapple. For a more complete list, refer to the PDF document on this disc. Greens. Remember those elementary school science classes where you learned about chlorophyll and its important role in photosynthesis, where plants emit the critical oxygen we breathe? Well, it's that same chlorophyll that gives green fruits and vegetables their color. Some members of the green group, such as spinach and other dark leafy greens, celery, cucumbers, green peppers, and peas, contain an important compound called lutein. It's believed that lutein helps prevent eye diseases, including age-related macular degeneration, cataracts, and retinitis pigmentosa. While more studies need to be conducted to confirm its other benefits, many scientists believe it can prevent colon cancer, breast cancer, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease. Members of this group also contain a group of antioxidants called indoles, which are believed to help protect against some types of cancer. Indoles can be found in broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, bok choy, arugula, turnips, rutabaga, and other cruciferous vegetables. Leafy green vegetables in this group are also rich in a vitamin B called folate, a compound important for pregnant women to consume to prevent birth defects in the newborn, which are called neural tube defects and affect the brain and spinal cord. The two most common defects are spina bifida and anencephaly. Much of the brain doesn't develop. Here is a list of some examples from this group. Artichokes, green onions, honeydew melon, broccoli, lime, asparagus. For a more complete list, please refer to the PDF document on this CD. Blues and purples. The fruits and vegetables in this group are colored by the natural plant pigments, anthocyanins. Found in such foods as grapes, raisins, blueberries, and blackberries, these compounds function as powerful antioxidants that protect cells from damage. Some evidence suggests that they can be helpful in reducing the risk for some serious diseases, such as heart disease, cancer, and stroke. Here are a few examples of the foods in this group. Blackberries, purple grapes, eggplant, figs, and raisins. For a more complete list, refer to the PDF document on this CD. Frozen fruits and veggies. Many people, doctors, nutritionists, and foodies would have you believe that frozen fruits and veggies are either unhealthy or not as nutritious as fresh ones. The truth, however, is that these frozen goodies can be equally healthy depending on the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.